I thought the first day I'm gonna walk there. And a pilgrimage is a sacred act. It's a way of expressing your devotion to God, to move from one place to another. It's an outward act in that we're really gonna walk, and it's 3 miles, and Wildens have already walked there here, so it's safe. They've cleared the way. But it is a sacred act. So it's an outward of really, you know, testing yourself physically. But it's also an inward act. And it's all about prepositions. I used to be an English teacher. It's all about prepositions. So we're going from, and for the last year, this has been my place. I've been on sabbatical, and I've been working here and doing a special project and really getting my heart right. And so I'm walking from this, and then it's walking to. Remember prepositions? You know, yeah. You learned about the squirrel goes from, yeah. To, around, all that. So it's walking to. So it's walking to a sacred place, to a new place that I'm going to be serving. And I'm super excited. I haven't slept lately. I can't eat. So I'm really, really excited. It's also walking through. So walking through the neighborhoods that we're going to be walking through, and being reminded that there are neighbors. So for you, I hope it's sacred as well, that whatever it is you're walking from, and God always leads us out of whatever struggles or troubles we have, God leads us out of that. So I hope it's a from, whatever you're walking from, and I hope it's to a sacred time and a sacred place for you personally, and taking us through what we're going through. But church, I want to ask you this, where are you walking to? I mean, a church is a place of movement. Where are we moving to? Where are we headed to? What's ahead for us? And it's a walk in from. So here we go. Let me just ask you this. Do you love this city? Do you love Iowa? Do you love, yeah. So we're walking through a good earth that we've been offered. So how do we make a difference in walking through this place? So join me in a moment of prayer, and then I have a few introductions and some instructions. So join me in prayer. Lord, guide our feet. Guide our feet, guide our lives, guide our souls, guide our hands. Lead us in the direction that you would have us go. From whatever we need to leave behind, to a glorious future that you have planned for us, through a community where we can express our love. All of this, Lord, we place in the strong and certain name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I want to introduce some people to you, some people that are dear in my heart. A lot of you already know my husband, but I don't know where he is. He's right here. This is my husband, Dave, and more than that, like, he will make sure I get to church, because he, like, drives and turns on lights and he secures places and he does all that. So I'm blessed to have Dave. These are my kids, some of them. So this is Lisa. Lisa's our youngest daughter. Some of you haven't seen her, like, in a decade. She used to be smaller. And she just recently moved back from Colorado, just less than a month ago. She's a psychologist. She works with Carolyn. Where's Carolyn? There she is. She works with Carolyn at Orchard Place and just started that job. Got her first paycheck yesterday. I know, and benefits. And this is her husband, Ryan. Ryan is attending the Law Enforcement Academy at Camp Dodge. He's preparing to be a deputy sheriff in Madison County.
Yay.
So they're going to be moving to Winter.
We're Madison County.
He will be your law enforcement.
I'm afraid of that. Behave
yourself. Don't soil their name. Look at their address. And this is one of their two dogs. This is Rocky. This is our older daughter, Lynn. Lynn lives in Urbandale, and she's an attorney. Her office is in Altoona. Her husband right now, he's an electrician. He's working so that we have electricity, so he's not here. This is our only granddaughter. This is Auden. She's 7, and she is with Lisa's adorable dog, Rocky. She will make sure all of you pet. And Auden's going into second grade. And then some other introductions I want to make for you. Lee Schott is here. Right there. And Lee is, Lee and I went to seminary together, and we spent a lot of time pilgrimage from here to seminary on I-35. And Lee is the pastor at Women at the Well in Mitchellville Prison, so that's what she does. So glad to have her walking today. And then I want to introduce you to Hee-chan G. Jian, who's back here. He is our district superintendent, and some of you have met him. Super good to work with, and just really been a blessing to our district. Okay, so excited to have him walking today as well. I don't know if there's, I encourage you to get to know each other. I came from smaller churches where we all knew each other. And knowing each other relationship is so important, so I hope you'll take an opportunity to do that. A few just words of caution today, please stay on the sidewalk just out of respect for our neighbors. We don't have a parade permit, so don't act like one. This morning I thought I could get candy, we could like throw candy.
It wasn't supposed to bring a sign?
You weren't supposed to, no sign.
No candy?
No candy. And don't throw water bottles at me.
She looks at me for that.
As we pass by houses, if you could, you know, think about who lives there and pray for them. This is our community, our opportunity to love them. We're going to go through two